while DT is still doing damage in the main. All of the SCVs have been pulled. Phoenix no longer mining, so pretty much what he has in his opponent's natural is it. And wow, Phoenix actually just calls the GG.
Wow, that's really strange, because I don't know, he could have been okay. I don't know. So, apparently we had some technical issues. I think the stream's back.
Hi, guys.
Why don't you guys let me know how that's all working?
I missed you.
So?
Looks like it's back.
Is it back?
It's back on my preview screen.
Let me tell you guys what happened. I'm just going to let them. It's like, who won? I don't know why it's dropping. I'm actually getting initialization errors from Twitch TV. That's what the message I was getting. Because XSplit was still running. Yeah, we can go into the replay. I'll do that real quick. Unless we have another game ready to go, because that's the end of that series. Luca, why don't you let me know?
We do. He already invited me.
Okay, never mind. Moving on.
I'll give you a quick recap. Inori did a lot of harassment with his Blink Stalkers. Phoenix got Stim and Medvax and went for a push. Inori warped in DTs in Phoenix's main, and Phoenix did not have enough scans for his main.
Whoa.
And Inori's natural, so Phoenix had to tap out. GG.
All right, well, there we go. All right, I think we're back and ready to go. TSL Inori. Moving on to
round of four. We are now in the semis.
Are we really?
Yes.
Okay. Well, that was quick.
Yeah, so best of three semis, best of five finals here. And this is a PvP. Sorry for the noise. I need more candy.
Because you are a giant child.
Nom, 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 nom.
You know...
Yeah?
We're going to have a great time at MLG Anaheim. Me and you.
If only I could go.
You will. I'll be sure of it. Man, I've got a lot of stuff to organize for the next, like, week.
I'm sorry, buddy.
No, like, good stuff.
Oh, well, then I'm not sorry. I'm jealous.
Got the CSL Grand Finals. Got MLG. It's going to be good. All right, guys. Well, I hope everything's back and working. This is the Playhem sponsored GGA, which stands for...
Do you know it? Do you know it?
I don't.
You got it?
I know. I don't remember.
Global Gaming Alliance, guys. These guys are bringing you this tournament. Put up the prize pool. And the cool thing is, this is just the first of many qualifiers for a $5,000 grand final tournament. Azio, Levitron, AMD bringing this to you guys, so please, please, please give them your support. They are dropping so much money for this tournament, so much money for our community. They love us. Love them back, guys.
All right, well, here we have spawning as the Purple Protoss here on GSL Belshire Beach Winter Edition. It is Melancholy. Hopefully,
sorry, I was swallowing candy.
I don't care. You do what you need to do. Over here at the top side of the map, we have TSL Inori.
Guys, I want a one in chat right now if you love candy.
Oh, God. Oh, Billy. Candy.
Come on. And yeah, sorry, if we're still having technical issues, guys. We're trying. It's not our fault. Twitch is having some problems tonight.
I like the way that you just decided that was the issue. You're just like, must
it
be
is.
Twitch's fault. It's like, Shane wouldn't lie.
Wait, were you lying
no,
to me?
No, no.
You lied to me.
No,
I can't believe you lied.
It said Twitch initialization error, so I assume it's on Twitch's side because it was still broadcasting.
I can't believe you lied to me.
Oh, God. You are just a commitophobe.
You just said you lied to me.
No, I said... No, that's not what I said. Go watch the VOD later.
No one likes candy.
No one likes candy.
Guys, one if Shane lied to me.
Zero if Shane's awesome. Actually, any other response other than one will get you on that one. In fact, just bitching about the stream also means I'm awesome. Similar builds coming out, deciding not to chrono boost out the Zealot. Plenty of chrono boost remaining on TSL in Nori's Nexus. Makes me think. Four. Great.
Yeah, this map actually, it's a lot like Tauterine because of this wider natural that doesn't have a ramp. You can't hold a four gate with force fields. You just, like, you can't do it. So this is actually another pretty much four gate or anti-four gate map. You can do, like, a three gate blink, or a three gate, like, straight stalker build that can hold four gate. Or you can four gate. Pretty cool how that works. Looks like Inori, he took a second gas. Because he wants the tech, but once he scouts his opponent's base and sees no second gas taken, he realizes, yeah, we're four gating, aren't we? Although Inori actually only dropping three gates here.
Well,
a little interesting.
Yeah, I think it's
melancholy.
I think it's going to be the Blink Stalkers.
Yeah, but he's not mining out of the second gas. He can't.
Oh, and melancholy. Look at this. That's a little preemptive. Oh, Billy, is it going to get up?
Oh man, yeah, Melancholy is four-gating. Like, there is no doubt that Melancholy is four-gating. I feel like at this point, Inori, yeah, he's just now putting down the fourth gate. He realizes this fourth gate is a little behind, but his Stalker Micro is so much better than his opponent's that, wow, he actually just pushes Melancholy back at this point, and Melancholy's four-gate is in a bit of trouble. He's committed. He's dropped two offensive pylons. He has the four-gate. But yeah, he's already lost so much. Inori, even with three gates, might be able to hold here.
Oh, he's got a fourth gate on the way right now. Should focus down the Hurt Stalker. Yes.
Oh, man.
Yes. Yes.
Wow, pretty even trade, which is nice for Melancholy because he had to deal with that Zealot dancing around. So good thing he got an even trade there. But Inori's just getting his fourth gate up here. Gonna have equal warpins. This is all micro at this point.
You know who's pretty good at micro?
Inori.
TSL Inori.
Yeah, but he's getting forced back right now, and there's actually a Zealot sneaking into his mineral line here, killing some probes. That's a huge deal when it's 4-gate versus 4-gate. Melancholy just takes two probes out and pulls back, knowing he's hurt the economy of his opponent ever so slightly. Oh man. So many cool things going on here. Crazy micro battle. Inori has the Stalker lead, but Melancholy has the Zealot lead. That means Inori has to kite like a mofo.
I think he's capable of that. I think he's capable of it. Oh, Stalker getting weak out in the front there for Inori. Oh, beautiful. Gets it into the back.
Yeah, Melancholy just being outclassed at this point. His Zealot's getting sniped off before they can hit the Stalkers at all. Inori getting a huge Stalker lead. Well, Melancholy is stuck on Zealots because of his low gas count. Oh man, there goes some Stalkers for Inori. Bit of a blunder, but I think Inori's got enough to push this back at this point.
Oh,
maybe not.
It's hard to
pushing forward.
Hard to
Inori
tell.
Inori loses two more Stalkers.
Oh, Inori!
Oh man, this is so close.
Oh, chasing it. It's just neck and neck, but... Oh, another round of warpins, and here we go again. The mental stamina required for this, guys, is extreme.
Yeah, this is one of the most stressful situations you can be in as any player, especially this deep in a tournament. But it's now five Stalkers to three Stalkers with only a Zealot lead for Melancholy. Oh, and Inori gets a good hit off there. Melancholy pulling the Hurt Stalker back. So back and forth.
All right, another... pack five Stalkers or five Zealots against five Zealots here. Zealot count even, at least for a moment. TSL and Nori now with a one Stalker lead, but one Stalker very hurt, just down to pretty much shields, very minimal hull. And oh, even another pylon coming down up here, even closer.
Oh man, both players getting supply blocked. That signals Melancholy to go for it because he doesn't want to miss warpins here. Great micro again, but oh, two Stalkers getting picked off by Melancholy, and that gives him a huge lead in the Stalker count now. Oh man, but he has to pull back as his Zealots disappear, and they are still neck and neck. Tons of chrono boost coming out from both players here, trying to get as many warpins as they can, but oh my goodness, a sentry coming out from Inori here. If that sentry builds up enough energy, oh, and a
Ooh, that was
Zealot
for free.
For free.
Yeah.
Yeah. Inori, during this time, has pumped out a couple more probes and gotten into the gas. Now, oh no, this could be so bad. Those two force fields could be exactly what he needs, but Melancholy being so smart with his zealots, oh my goodness.
I think that's it. I think TSL and Nori's out. Here's the chase.
Man. It's so close, but now these units are cut off from the reinforcements. They're about to get walled off. Oh, man. Nori has to be so careful with his own stalkers.
I can't tell who's winning.
I think Inori's going to push it back to the pylon again. This is crazy. We're at the 11-minute mark. Both players still forgating.
No economic done except for the two workers killed initially.
Yeah, Inori has a slight probe lead, which means he can produce slightly more, but also means he's going to mine out faster. Oh, man. Hurt Stalker's being pulled back by both players. Melancholy pushing forward a little greedily, and he almost loses a Stalker.
Oh, both those Zealots so hurt right now. Actually, getting pot shots on the Zealot as the warp in, it's not good at all. Basically,
yeah, Melancholy needs to pull back for a second. Let his Zealots recharge their shields. Oh, he loses a Stalker for free. And now Inori's got a really big Stalker advantage. This could be it. This is so many Stalkers here. Zealots chasing the wounded Stalker, but that gives Melancholy a little bit of time to shoot here. But if you look, Inori's now shot up in supply. He's up ahead by 7 here. I think Inori's got this. I mean, he's kiting back now because of all the hurt Zealots, but yeah, there are only 2 Stalkers left for Melancholy for the, like, 7 of Inori. Inori just got 3 more Stalker warp-ins. Wow, yeah, Inori takes
this.
Has to back off, but I mean, what can Melancholy do? Inori's already got a second gas. Melancholy's going to lose 2 of his offensive pylons here. Inori, ahead on the probes, ahead on the gas, and he has a chance to do a ton of damage with a counter.
You know what he doesn't have is a proxy pylon or a probe even with that group. Is that okay?
I think it is. I think he's just got too many Stalkers, especially with his opponent being supply blocked.
Huh.
Yeah, his opponent severely supply blocked. Got a pylon down, but it only allowed him to get 1 warp in here. He is going to have enough for force fields, but only manages to catch 1 Stalker there. Oh, man. And meanwhile, Inori is able to tech into blink, whereas Melancholy is just stuck with defensive warp-ins right now. I mean, just look at the resources here. TSL Inori can just do whatever he wants out of this, whereas Melancholy is panicking to survive.
That's true. So very true. And plenty of minerals getting banked up right now. He spends them all. Yeah, the blink. And
blink and 4 Stalkers. And at this point, Inori's just going to hang out outside of his base until... Oh, he's going to poke a little bit here. He needs to be careful not to get force fielded, but yeah, he's just going to wait for blink. Probably chrono boost the heck out of blink. And then he's going to go for a battle. I don't see Melancholy being able to win.
Both players are actually getting very close to being mined out as well.
That's true.
Will be mined out within the next minute. So every unit counts right now because there will be no time to get a Nexus. Oh man, that's huge.
Two wasted force fields there. I think Inori, Blink, getting really close to being done. Melancholy, there's no longer enough resources left in his base to tech out of Forgate.
I think when Melancholy sees the Blink, he's going to GG.
Yeah. I mean, his Forgate was so close to working. He doesn't want to give up, but he sees the Stalker count. He knows in the back of his head how much trouble he's in. Trying to get anything he can, but there's so many Stalkers. Oh, man.
There we go. GG.
GG.
Oh, my God. That was intense. 16 minutes of Forgate.
Crazy first game. Holy cow.
Yes. First game, correct. All right, guys, we're going to take a quick commercial break and hopefully won't have any more problems with the stream. Stay tuned. This is the GGA qualifier hosted by Playham.